Welcome to the Elxpro Tips, and today we're going to be talking about live view and geolocalization. I'm going to give you an introduction, and I'm so excited to explain to you this amazing tips because I know that you can replicate and do it in your personal project and even in your company as well. Let me share my screen and let's start. So, first of all, just ignore this because this is related to distributed applications. And what we have here, we have an app where if I go over here and just make the inspect here available, when I click here and click here again, we added products to our cart. Gus, what is this app? So here on the Elxpro, I have a Elixir course where I teach you basic Elixir until you deploy real-time live view applications using distributed systems with Google Cloud and Live View as well. If you want to build this app, you can join to Elxpro in some links that we have here. But you can do this tutorial in every live view application. I just recommend you to create a component. And if you know about hooks, it's good, but if you don't, I'm gonna give you some videos that you can watch and follow this tutorial. Let's go ahead. So this is a live application. So as you can see, we have the address here. We're gonna add, using our location, a possible address here. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna go to this field. So it's an input type here. We're gonna use the hooks here, so you can add an ID here called address and PHX hook. If you don't know what I'm doing, as I mentioned, I'm going to share some tutorials with you and some links as well. The main goal here is to do it faster, but you can watch the tutorials if some knowledge for you are missing. So right here, when we do it and go back here, as you can see, the hook, it's on, we didn't find the hook. So what we're gonna do is we can go to, if you don't know how hooks works, so I usually create this hooks folder, and then I start creating my hooks. Here we can say get address, same one here, which is the same name. We need to create the file. I think this one is the most straightforward to copy and paste. Just duplicate it. And then we can create saying that get address.js, changing the name, get address. And when we do it, and then we can say console log this, which is the most important thing. I'm going to give you an introduction how hooks works. And after that, so we get addresses from the client and relay. Let me check here. So the name is get address. Go to our app, go to our hook. There you go. Oh, just one more thing, just duplicate one. And probably now it's gonna work. And there you go. We get our hook. And the most important thing is our element, which is this EL. This is where we're gonna work. And our first step, what we're gonna do here, what we're gonna do is let's start checking the value and change stuff. So if we go to the address here, we get the element, what we can do is this EL and the value, which is input, we can say pumpkin 123. And when we go back here, you can see now we can change this value, but let's start using the live view to do it. But before, what we need to do, I'm going to give you some links to understand a little bit more, but for now we have the navigator by default and we have the geolocation. And if we have it, what we want to do is you can use the console.log to understand the navigator. I lost a little bit, but I'm back. So now what we're gonna do is just collecting some stuff here. And what we're gonna there you go. So what do we have when we do it? So as you can see, I'm gonna start trying to build our app here. Let me see the console. As you can see, we got our navigator and have a lot of things. So you can do a lot of things with your hooks and with your Elixir apps. And the main goal here, geolocation does not exist because they didn't access that. My apologize for you. But the main focus here is start getting our latitude and longitude. What we can do here is navigator dot geolocation dot get current position. Then we have our position. And in our position, we have a couple of data. You can debug the position here, but basically we have the const latitude using the POS dot ports dot latitude, same one for the LNG. LNG using the longitude right here. So we got this information, and the most important is that now let's start using the hooks. So what we're going to do is we need to access, as I mentioned, in this case, we're using the component. So I highly recommend you to create a component in your page to follow this tutorial. Press event to, I'm going to give the ID where we are going to send. In our case, in my case here, so I have the page, which is the cart live, and we have this cart details here. But when we go over here, so I highly recommend, let's just show to you, then I will show you more one more thing. Basically, we want the cart tails. And this is where we're gonna send, because if we don't send this information, it's going to trigger the parent, it's going to trigger the page, and we wanna trigger the component. Then we can say that get address. And after sending this, we're gonna send some params, in our case, lat and LNG. And we want to get this information as well from our Elixir app. So it's going to return for us the reply and the reference. So after that, let's see what's going to happen. First thing that's going to happen here is that it's going to complain for us that it's going to throw an error saying that we don't have the hook or something like that. Let's see. Let me just refresh the page once again. Events two seems that it's not loaded, I think, because it didn't trigger our application probably, or it does. Just make one change. Yeah, so the cart details does not exist because I created a component, but I'm not using the ID for my component. So I highly recommend you to do that. I did it with one purpose. So when we have it, and when both when we have the location now, what's going to happen is that it's going to throw an error saying that the handle event does not exist. Here is, we don't have the error, but probably it didn't trigger our hook because I'm just going to move this step here to this one because I want to change the value. So as you could see, the address is not here. When we see the address here, we can start triggering the, you can see the error. So let's wait a little bit more. There you go. Amazing, fantastic. We got the error saying that we don't have the handle event here. Probably we already have it. So let's go ahead here to our cart details. Let's create our handle event. Just yes for me, please. Handle event. Where the event that we created is the get address. So we got params. And now what we're gonna do is instead of following the same pattern, we're gonna say reply. And I want to reply the address where the address for now is backend address coming. And let's return the socket right here. And because we have the address here, change here. Because we have the address, we got the reply, we can say const address coming from the reply. And let's just change this line over here to this one. So now because we have the address here, if we come over here, let's wait. Now the backend address is coming, which means that we are gonna get the address from our LiveView application. So what we are gonna do is, because we have this information, we can come over here, creating a context called get address. And now we can say that we have, as you can see, we have the latitude and longitude, execute params. This is gonna be enough for us. And now we can come over here to our food order. Let's create the file getAddress.ex. F module where we have the execute where in our params we will have something like this one. I'm just going to copy this. Let's change this to LAT. And let's change this to LNG and do. Now we have the pinch. So in our case specifically, as I mentioned, I'm going to give you all the details on this video. You can check all the resources, but basically we want the location something like this one, where we have LAT, LNG, and then we have the access key. It comes from, I'm going to just copy and paste this value. So it means you need to create your own. So in the API that we are going to consume is the pinch dot field, and the method is get. The URL I'm gonna give to you as well. you can see this URL and just make the change. And after that, what we're gonna do is something like change.request, and then you need to send your Finch app name. In my case, and probably yours, you can go to the application, just copy this Finch name. Here, and then we can say IO inspect, and then we can say that the phrase will be calling my address for now, and save that. When we save this one and go back to the address here, let's close all of them. As you can see, let's wait. So we're connecting our socket. Let me just refresh once again. Finch calling my address, something like that. Then we can start building response. And we're going to start handling with this kind of data. And to do it, as you can see, we got like the response, which is okay, and the status is to 100. So let's start working on this method, this function. When it's wherever, we can say API error, but in our case, build response with a tuples thing, okay. The status, as we can see for this API, is 200, where we have body, and what we're gonna do is we got the body, we're gonna say doesn't decode this one. I don't care if something goes wrong, going to blow up, but in our case it's just a tick. And then function where we have data, what we're gonna do is take the data, let's just get the label information. So let me just make this one simpler, easier to read. When you go to this app now and refresh the page, let's see. So it get the first address. You can take a look on this API as well. And if you want to build this app or build this feature in this app, you can join to Elxpro. I hope you're enjoying this tutorial. See you and bye-bye.